I don't know about you, but I am always behind. And I'm always behind because I am so optimistic about my ability to complete tasks in an unrealistically short amount of time. Over the course of a week, this leads to me being like a day behind, and then I need to work nights or weekends to catch up before I move into the next week. And this has led into a cycle of me just being tired and overworked in a way that feels really unnecessary. And so I said, enough is enough, I'm going to figure this out. And so I started doing some research, and turns out there has been a lot of studies done, and there's a lot of good tips and tricks out there for actually fixing this. Today, I'd like to share what some of those findings say and 5 tips for actually estimating how long something will take you accurately. This widespread phenomenon is called the planning fallacy. This 1977 study conducted by Amos Tversky and Daniel Kahneman was groundbreaking in this area of psychology research. This study talks about people's tendency to disregard historical data when making predictions. Instead, the study argued, we tend to focus solely on the upcoming task. We might think painting a room will only take us 2 days because last time it took 3 days and we're better at it now, right? So it'll probably take 2 days. It's this kind of thinking that has gotten me into the place I'm at right now. So here are 5 different ways to avoid underestimating how long a project will take, backed by science. Number 1, use historical data. This might seem obvious, but it had never occurred to my brain to actually keep track of how long projects take. So I recently started using a time tracker. The one I used is called Toggle. It's been great so far. All of the features I need are available in the free version. Now I will have historical data to back up how long tasks took me when I'm scheduling for future tasks. Number 2, have someone else estimate for you. A 1994 study published in the Journal of Personality and Social Psychology found that people are pretty bad at estimating how long something will take them, but they are very good at estimating how long something will take someone else. That's because they often rely on historical data rather than just making an optimistic guess. For me, I'm going to plan to start asking Abby to come in and at least review my plans for the next week when I do my weekly planning session to make sure that my estimates seem accurate. She'll ask me some questions about how long this has taken in the past, or if that seems pretty unrealistic based on how long it's taken you before. Because regardless of how optimistic I am, that YouTube video isn't gonna take any shorter than 25 hours, even if I only budget 7 hours for it. Number 3, estimate in ranges or build in time for delays. All projects, no matter how large or small, have variables. Some have some very obvious variables, known variables. Others have variables that we might know or things that might happen. Others have variables that probably won't happen. And then there's other variables that we just never considered. All of these could factor into a project. So estimating can be difficult. One project management tool I remember learning about in university was called the cone of uncertainty. The basic concept is the earlier in the project we are, the more prone to error any estimate of the project will be. The closer and closer the project gets to completion, the more accurate our estimates will be. To give an example, this fall, there are 8 VFX shots I need to complete for a short film that is due at the end of December. Now, I've done very little VFX before, and so I don't know all the variables, but there are some known. So I do know that there are 8 shots, and I know that there is a deadline of the end of December. I also did some initial research on how long something like this should take, and estimates were showing me in a range of 10 to 20 hours. So I'm estimating initially 15 hours. Now, that is probably an optimistic estimate. Based on the cone of uncertainty at this stage in the process, the variability in our estimate can be anywhere between 1/4 of the time we estimated to 4 times the amount we've estimated. So based on that, anywhere between 4 hours and 60 hours. Now, I don't really think this project is going to take me 4 hours, and I think 15 hours might even be optimistic. So if I'm planning for it, I'm going to plan at least 60 hours worth of time to complete this project. Now, as I move further and further along in the project, I will have a much more accurate estimate of how long this project will take me. The other key part to this model is building in time for delays. So this project is due at the end of December. It would be very wise of me to start this project soon, and so that I'm not cramming the last week of December to finish this project. Number four, use a 3-point estimation. Make a best case scenario estimate, a worst case scenario estimate, and a most likely scenario estimate. So maybe you're working on a project and you optimistically guess, it'll take me 2 days off the top of your head. But then you think back to last year when it actually took you 5 days to do a similar scale of project. Okay, that's your realistic, most likely scenario estimate. But what if everything possible went wrong? You had to start the project over several times, things were just falling apart. Well, worst case scenario, you could do it in 10 days. So the idea here is then to take those estimates, the 2 days, the 5 days, and the 10 days, add those up and divide by three, and then you'll get a pretty accurate estimate to what that would be. So in our case, that would be something like 5.5. Number five, calculate your fudge ratio. This one is a lot of fun and I'm looking forward to integrating it into my own life. So this idea comes from productivity author Steve Pavlina. And he recommends measuring your current estimation accuracy to create something called your fudge ratio. The basic concept here is to create a to-do list for a week or a short amount of time with a variety of tasks on it. Ideally, these tasks in total should sum somewhere between 10 and 20 hours and should be some smaller tasks, like tasks you can do in a single sitting, anywhere from 15 minutes to a number of hours. Now, write down an off-the-cuff estimate of how long you think each of these tasks is going to take. Then do the tasks and write down how long they actually took you. So let's say that I estimated my tasks would take me 12 hours and they took me 18 hours. Now, some took less time than I expected, some took as long as expected, some took twice as long as I expected, and maybe one outlier took 5 times as long as expected. Well, on average, when I sum those up, you realize that my fudge ratio is 1.5 to 1. Tasks took me 1.5 times longer on average than I expected. Pavlina went on to say that his initial estimates did not improve, but what he started doing was using those initial estimates times his fudge ratio to create how much time things will actually take. He also went way more in depth with this, so I'll leave the rest of his article linked down in the description. So there it is. That is 5 different methods for solving the planning fallacy that we are very prone to. I hope this was helpful to you. I know this was hugely helpful to me. I was doing this research anyways for myself, so I thought I might as well share it. I want to leave you with one idea. This idea has been attributed to many different people, but it seems to be a universal truth. People overestimate what they can do in a day and underestimate what they can do in a year.